Fields were changing from yellow stubble to brown earth, and a tractor was hard at work as Thomas puffed along. Later, Thomas saw the tractor close by. "Hello," said the tractor. "I'm Terence. I'm plowing." "I'm Thomas. I'm pulling a train. What ugly wheels you've got." "They're not ugly, they're caterpillars," said Terence. "I can go anywhere. I don't need rails." "I don't want to go anywhere," said Thomas. "I like my rails, thank you." Winter came with dark clouds full of snow. "I don't like it," said Thomas's driver. "A heavy fall is coming. I hope it doesn't stop us." "Phew," said Thomas. "Soft stuff, nothing to it." And he puffed on, feeling cold but confident. They finished their journey safely, but by now the country was covered. "You need your snowplow for the next journey, Thomas," said his driver. "Huh! Snow is silly soft stuff. It won't stop." The snowplow was heavy and uncomfortable and made Thomas cross. He shook it and he banged it. When they got back, it was so damaged that the driver had to take it off. "Turn on the engine," he said to Thomas. Next morning, Thomas's driver and fireman came early and worked on the snowplow, but they couldn't make it fit. Thomas was pleased. "I shan't have to wear it. I shan't have to wear it," he puffed to Annie and Clarabelle. They were rather worried. I hope it's all right, they whispered to each other. The driver was worried, too. "It's not bad here," he said to the fireman, "but it's sure to be deep in the valley." "Silly soft stuff," puffed Thomas. "I didn't need that stupid old thing yesterday, and I shan't today. Snow can't stop me." He rushed into a tunnel, thinking how clever he was, but there was trouble ahead. "Send us in ashes," said Thomas. "I'm stuck." And he was. "Back, Thomas, back," said his driver. Thomas tried, but his wheels spun and he couldn't move. The conductor went back for help, while everyone else tried to dig the snow away. But as fast as they dug, more snow slipped down until Thomas was nearly buried. "Oh, my wheels and coupling rods! I shall have to stop here till I'm frozen. What a silly engine I am!" And Thomas began to cry. At last, a bus came to rescue the passengers. And then, but Terence, snow never hurts him. "Try," said Thomas, and he puffed slowly away.